I wanted to be a police officer. So I run over to an opportunity. They're going to form a cadet program for 18-year-olds to 21-year-olds, and then you could go in there and work with them in non-policing jobs, and then you get into the police academy when you turn 21. So I go over there and I take the written test, and I don't pass. I fail it. Oh God! I mean, my whole life is collapsing now. And so I go home. Now my father and I move back to the house, and so he's on the front porch, and God bless him. And this is not criticism. It's just I'm just giving you the truth. So he's on the front porch. You know, he's kind of having a beer or two, and I'm feeling pretty low. So I walk up, and he says, "You look like something bothering you." I says, "Yeah, you know, I'm really upset." He says, "What are you upset about?" And I says, "Well, I took the cadet test for the LAPD. Now remember, you know, I'm on the bus going to do this stuff, and so I'm not really, you know, that mobile. And so that kind of affects you too, that you don't really have the independence to kind of like succeed the way you want to." So I go, and he says, "I didn't pass it." He says, "Well," he looked at me, he says, "Well, I didn't think you'd pass it anyway." Well, let me tell you folks, if there's ever a wake-up call about what you really need to do in life, it's when someone that's closest to you tells you something like that, because you better wake up fast. And so naturally, you know, being a little bit vulnerable at the moment, you know, I just immediately walked into the house, went out in the backyard, and had a good cry. You know, sometimes you just got to do that. Sometimes you just got to say, "I don't know if I can take this. You know, I don't want to do something that is going to cause me to lose my hope about what life's all about and what my abilities are. I just don't know if I can take a parent that doesn't care." Okay? And so what that then did is I got a lot more tougher about myself. And I said, "Hey, if you don't do it, because grandparents don't know where to go with colleges, and father doesn't know where to go with colleges, and no one around you is really aspirating for college, so you better get yourself a mindset that allows you to go with the flow for now, and then get serious about when you want to really make your move." And so that's kind of where I think was the lowest point in my life, quite frankly, was that experience about losing the dream. You know, and that can happen to anybody. You can try your best, and I thought I was doing my best, but I knew I really wasn't doing my best. But when you start to lose the dream, you can get in real trouble fast. But I didn't, because I'm not disposed for self-destruction. I'm not going to go out and get drunk. I'm not going to go out and do something outrageous. I'm not going to steal. I'm not going to do any of those things. I'm just going to kind of get tactical, think about it, figure it out, and then set a goal and don't stop.